Seems he was guarding that way outside.
Almost looks familiar, but different. Like a confused memory.
A rather hostile memory at that.
These fates should know I will not be deterred.
Brother, I had a thought. What if we took a stealthy approach to our next battle?
No.
Of the Æsir.
Ah, here we go.
Counselor to kings. Merry wanderer of the woods. Robin of the good fellows.
Let me guess. I'm a long-winded know-it-all and I cannot change. See? You forgot the smartest man alive. Certainly clinks like genuine hack silver. I suppose there's one small consolation to this ordeal. At least we won't have to introduce ourselves.
Don't credit your reputation, Mimir. They see the whole lives of any who approach them.
What is that?
A phantom! Rogue magic! Aim for the runic core!
Bloody hell! Look at that thing!
It's horrible when it glows!
The core first, then the spring! Leave yourself an opening! Don't waste it! Another gift of Fimbulwinter, I suppose.
The magic draining out of all of us has to end up somewhere.
This way.
The Norns are somewhere in that cave just ahead.
There's that itchy sound again. Normally, I don't mind ladies whispering in my ear, but this is positively irksome.
Anyone ever tell you that you babble when you're terrified?
Terrified? I'll have you know I'm at the very most deeply apprehensive. And breaking tension with humor is the sacred duty of a traveling companion. How very dare you! Babbling!
A door.
Oh, that looks official.
To me, please.
Stop! Why did you bring him here? You are not welcome here!
Wait! Baldur, come back! Talk to me!
I am so sick of your constant
what you did to me.
What you did to me!
You
will not touch him. You will not harm him. Nobody harms my boy. But me. No!
Freya!
Brother, over here. Come get me. I want none of this.
Mimir!
Sigrun? Brother, hold off.
Why did you never turn on Odin?
But I did. I tried to stop him any way I could.
Don't lie to me! You served Odin from the day you met to the day he put you in that tree! You sought favor. You wanted his war. You watched him mistreat everyone and everything. And you never gave a shit until you turned on you.
I know, Sigrun. It's true. All of it. But for love of you, I became a better man. A counselor for peace, an ally to all those who...
Were you an ally to Freya in her suffering? To Skadi? To Kratos? Or to Tanya? No! You always took the side of the powerful. Brother,
watch out! There's more of them!
Even now, you see a violent god in need, and you can't help but aid him and call him brother! It's who you always been! Who you are! And it's who you are!
It is not her.
No. Of course. You did what you must. Brother, the tree! It's pulling me in!
Mimir!
Brother, help me! Monster!
Atreus! I am coming!
Why didn't you trust your own son?
Don't let him take you!
Atreus!
I'm scared!
Why wouldn't we see him the way he wants to be seen?
I don't want to go back! You're a liar! He's a murderer!
That's all I have to do. Now he's mine!
He killed my family!
Atreus! I am here!
Help!
is over. Did we pass the test?
Didn't feel much like succeeding.
I see the door has disappeared.
Or it was never there.
They toy with us still. What is that?
A Kelpie. Don't see many of those in these parts.
She must be theirs.
Will she take us to them?
I'll ask her. Nicely. Easy, girl. Easy. That's right. Good.
Care to talk about whatever the Norns put you through?
No.
Get on.
That's a good lass. Lovely creatures, but temperamental by reputation. In my land, they'd keep children away from the lochs by telling them a Kelpie would drown them. Of course, no Kelpie I know would do such a thing. Unless it was disrespected.
It walks on water.
Aye. No mystical water steeds to speak of in Greece, brother?
There were the hippocamps. They served the sea god. I battled one upon a titan.
That might not be her favorite subject. Here.
Fate's own hideaway. Never doubted we'd make it.
Kratos, Freya, and Mimir's head. Enter the home of the Norns, tentatively. They have finally reached their destination. Kratos speaks first.
I seek my son!
You know the child is an Asgard. No, you seek what all who search for us seek. To know the ending to your story. The ghost of Sparta furrows his brow menacingly. He resists the urge to grunt. Oh, he fails. You come to us, piteous archetypes, seeking freedom from your scripts. As if knowing your lines would grant you the power to rewrite them.
Speak plain.
You will die, Kratos of Sparta.
But you called him the destroyer of fate.
There must be a way to subvert destiny.
There is no destiny, Puck.
Protagonists are speechless. They do not understand.
There is no grand design, no script. Only the choices you make. That your choices are so predictable merely make us seem prescient.
When my son was born...
Shut up!
Your prophecy said he would die a needless death.
And he did. Because you could not let him go. Because he thirsted for revenge. And because you kill gods.
But what Kratos did, it was not out of hate.
Should I bring him a crown then? He still slays gods, but now he's sad about it?
You are the sum of your choices, nothing more. And because your choices never change, you will learn that Heimdall intends to kill your son in Asgard, and you will do what you do best. And then Ragnarok.
The skies burn, the curtains fall. Exeunt omnes.
Heimdall.
Again, he misses the point.
Focusing on the second act to the exclusion of the final. A common mistake in storycraft.
We are leaving.
He stomps away, followed closely by Freya.
I enjoyed your story, Kratos. Pity it has to end so soon.
Well, that was educational.
Let us leave this place.
Happily.
That's better. I can feel things getting more normal already.
Wait. That tree.
Well, isn't that interesting?
What is this?
That's the noose, brother. The one Odin hanged himself with. As part of his endless mad quest for secrets of life and death and what have you.
What are you doing?
It's a charged object, significant to Odin. Perhaps I'll find a use for it.
Brother, what they said about the boy...
will not happen.
Oh, I agree.
It will not happen. We will not let it.
Of course we bloody won't. The question is how? You wouldn't seriously consider killing Heimdall, would you?
I will do what I must.
Oh, is that all?
You're wrong to dissuade him, Mimir. You know Heimdall.
I grant you that he's a spiteful, vicious little shit.
And so loyal, Odin entrusted him with Gjallarhorn. If we have the chance to eliminate him before Ragnarok, we shouldn't hesitate.
Considering his powers of foresight alone, that is an if of mountainous size. Even supposing we're all perfectly comfortable plotting an assassination, and I, for one, am a mite rusty at that measure, we've got no way to reach Heimdall, and no way to kill him if we did.
I have killed gods greater than him.
I don't doubt that, brother, but it's hardly my point.
Up there.
Look, I think we're missing the Norn's message here. We've all got our tendencies, and yours is to run headlong into danger to protect the ones you love.
I do not intend to change. Not about that.
Why should you? Apparently my tendency is to kill the ones I love.
Freya.
I don't need you to comfort me. Either of you.
Their accusation was cruel. None of us believe...
The truth can be a cruel thing. Anyone care to argue with that?
No. But Baldur's fate had many causes. Prophecy among them.
How do you mean, brother?
There are many tales in my homeland of those who fulfilled prophecy by attempting to avoid it. So it was when Freya tried to protect Baldur. And so it was when I accused my son of going to Asgard.
Then we agree. It'd be foolish to go after Heimdall.
No. If Heimdall must die for Atreus to live, then Heimdall must die.
How can you say that, knowing what you know?
Because if Heimdall is a threat to my son, I must act. It is my...
Your nature. Well played, Norns.
Thank you.
Let us find a gateway, return home, consider our plans.
Listen, brother. Before you make any hasty decisions, why don't you blow off a little steam? I'm sure there was some loose end we meant to circle back to. Give your mind a little time to process everything.
I suspect there's unfinished business here at the lake, so I'm certainly happy to spend time somewhere other than Midgard.
It's your choice, brother.
Norns have any good news for you?
No.
Ah. Maybe buying something expensive will take your mind off it? Want something in particular? Anything you want to talk about, Kratos? Whatever you need, whenever you need it.
Tell me of this power Heimdall wields. He sees the future.
More like he reads the person, sees their intention.
My intent will be to kill him. Knowing that will be no advantage.
Brother, this is no one to underestimate. Any move you make, he'll have seen it coming. If you must face him, we need something else. An edge. Humor me?
Very well. We will ask the dwarves.
Ah. The inevitable asking of the dwarves.
Excuse me, sir. Could I have a moment of your time?
Oh dear, what's to be done?
What is it you want?
It has come to my attention that Neathoak has been slain. And as a result, her offspring have been let loose into the Nine Realms.
What of it?
Unfortunately, without a proper role model to supervise them, the little rascals are certain to fall to mischief. In time, said mischief could culminate in nothing less than their devouring of the Nine Realms entirely. In order to avoid such a grisly fate, I'd like you to bring the Leanworms to me. I believe I can act as a satisfactory paternal figure in their upbringing. You'll find the specimens gnawing on tears throughout the realms. Use this device to safely store them, bring them back to me, and I promise I'll make it worth your while.
You mean to say you'd raise them by yourself?
Indeed. I have no small experience managing extreme personalities. Compared to wrestling with my emotions in the most literal of senses, I dare say raising a handful of leaned worms will be a walk in the park. All that said, I'm happy to discuss anything else on your mind. What else is there?
About Nithog. You should know, we had no choice. It was Odin's doing.
Oh, I am very well aware indeed of the alleged All-Father's role in this tragedy. Sadly, there's no expecting him to clean up after himself. Not all gods showed the interest that you do in righting past wrongs. I do hope you're able to locate those leanworms. Good luck to you. I suppose I needn't take up more of your time.
They're back. They're back!
Simmer down. I see them.
I have news.
Oh, did the Norns tell you how to get Atreus back? Do we have a plan?
The Norns say Atreus will be killed by Heimdall. The plan is to kill Heimdall first.
Oh, wow. Okay, Heimdall. Let's see. Never loses, sees everything coming, unpopular at parties. This won't be easy.
Whatever his advantages, I will overwhelm him with my own.
That's the idea. You gotta overpopulate his senses, see? And I got just the thing in mind to help you do it. Sindri, go get Dropnir.
Dropnir? But we need it. Our supplies.
Oh, we got plenty. And to spare.
Even if we did, Dropnir's no weapon. Why would a... Oh. You mean we combine it with...
That's right.
And then when he... It'll go... Damn you, that's brilliant. Very well. I suppose there's nothing to do, but... Go fetch Dropnir.
Dropnir. I bloody knew these two had nicked it. And Odin blamed me for it disappearing.
They stole Dropnir.
We didn't steal nothing. We just ungifted what never should have been gifted in the first place.
How will it help me kill Heimdall?
Never you mind all that. It's a fucking surprise. We're Artis.
But to even store Dropnir, you'd need...
You were saying...
Now you intend to kill Heimdall. Violence cannot prevent violence, Kratos. I truly thought you understood that.
No matter what you thought I understood, my son is in danger. I will not allow harm to come to him.
Oh, I'm gonna miss you, little one.
Got it!
I think.
I thought you didn't believe in fate. We are all worried about your son.
Enough! Heimdall's a threat, not only to Atreus, but to everyone. He's Odin's left hand, and he carries the horn that begins Ragnarok. If we have the chance to eliminate him, we
and
should...
And it's just as likely a trap, because the bastard knows your intentions. Kratos, I've never seen anyone so much as lay a finger on him. Not one.
Well, I gathered what's fit for gathering.
How long will it take?
We'll have to go to Svartalfheim to get the rest of the materials. Not to mention, we'll have to visit... The lady. Oh. Oh. Whew, that's a relief.
Huh?
Ow.
Kratos, whenever you're ready.
The lady?
No idea what he's on about, brother.
I don't like who I became on our last adventure. I can't be around the violence that follows him. That follows you both. I'm sorry.
I'm ready when you are.
I've been studying and I can forge some new equipment for you. I'm only just realizing all the little routines I've had to adopt taking care of Dropnir. I'll miss melting rings down for crafting gold, but I suppose we have enough to see us through to Ragnarok. Too soon?